What's going on, everyone? So we are doing
a toy hunt,
a daddy daughter toy hunt. We're all done with P Dog's gymnastics. It's Saturday, September. It's a stay at home day, yeah. It's Saturday, September 23rd, and we are going to
Walmart.
No.
Target. Yes.
We're going to Target, and we're gonna go to Hot Topic so that I can spend my hot cash because it expires tomorrow.
And poop.
But
and
we're gonna get a snack, and we're gonna get a toy.
Who's gonna get a toy?
Me and me.
You guys have money to buy toys?
Yeah.
So at Hot Topic, I'm looking for the Hopper and the hazmat suit from Stranger Things. I'm looking for, what other exclusives do they have? I don't know. I don't remember what other exclusives they have, but I will check it out there. I will use my hot cash. And I'm gonna throw your flip-flops out the window.
No.
Ready? Usually helps when the windows roll down.
No.
But we're gonna start at Target. We're gonna go to Target first, see what they got. Happy Batman Day, by the way.
Happy Batman Day.
Yes, today's Batman Day. And I pre-ordered the Batman Day MEZCO Ascending Knight exclusive figure from MEZCO's website this morning. That will probably be a limited figure since it's just for Batman Day. It's not a PX Previews exclusive or anything like that. You can only get it through MEZCO.
Batman!
So I ordered that one this morning from MEZCO's website. That doesn't ship till January or February, I think, next year. But I pre-ordered it. So we're gonna go on this toy hunt right now. We'll see you at Target. I do have to go to GameStop sometime this weekend as well
to get
NHL 18 because I think that's out. But I'll see you guys at Target. What? We should go to Walgreens too. We should go to Walgreens because I want to get that Spirit Ben, Ghost Ben, Black Series, and the. Ooh, I gave up on Marvel Legends. Do I want to get the Human Torch anyway? Ooh, yellow light. I gotta make it. Uh oh. Is it Popo? Is the popo?
No.
Are you ready? Okay. I can't shake her. Did you just pick a wedgie? Can hardly sleep, blood is in my dreams. I was killing me, trying to figure it out. Why?
Ooh, because. What? What is it?
You want a piece of poop with legs.
Lift on. That one and that one.
So we have some of those. Which ones do we not have?
We don't have this one or this one.
Motor melon and peely apple wheels? That's hard to say. Peely apple wheels. You gonna get some Legos? Let me see what you got. Don't you already have this one?
No. I have the one. What? I have the bulldog one.
Okay.
I have this dog.
All right. These are the Legos. These are the Legos that I like. Look at this. Rathtar Escape. That's awesome. Look at this bad boy. Where's the Batman Legos? For Batman Day.
Ooh.
Very tempting. Very, very tempting. $50. Make it light up.
Wow.
Ninjago movie. That, look at that dragon. So cool. Here it is right here. $50. And they've got the big robot, the mech. Garma Mecha Man. For $60. I've heard a lot of good things about this piece. The centerpiece box series. And this looks awesome. So many things that I would buy right now. So many things. Legos. Star Wars.
Boss Baby.
Transformers. Boss Baby. Gotta make a decision though. I like it.
What?
Good. Captain Captain P Dawg.
Yeah, Captain America.
Who has the best moves? All right, we are all done at Target. We have a little haul here. So first things first, Tay-Tay got a book. It's called Amelia Bedelia. There's your book. P-Dawg got this cutie car, and it is called Peely Apple Wheels. There you go. Toots. Tay-Tay also got this little Lego set called Puppy Pampering. For you, I got a movie, Steelbook, Target exclusive Steelbook. One of the best movies I've ever seen in my entire lifetime. Came out in the 80s. E.T. E.T. Steelbook, Blu-ray, DVD, digital HD. Bam. It's an awesome movie. One of the best movies ever. Steven Spielberg, E.T. I also scored some cool figs. I got, first of all, this is the first time I've ever seen this one in a store. Target exclusive NXT TakeOver, Seth freaking Rollins. Cue the music. Burn it down! Awesome figure. Back when he was the very first NXT champion. But again, first time I've ever seen that figure, so had to pick it up. And then I also got this guy, Octane, aka Octone. They didn't get the rights apparently to use the name Octane, but Triple Changer, Octane, loving the Titans Return line. Goes from jet mode to semi to big. Awesome robot. So there you go. Octane. He will join the ranks with Blitzwing and my other triple changers that I have. But very happy with this haul. I think we might be stopping at Hot Topic now. Or would you girls like to get lunch instead?
Lunch.
Lunch? Lunch?
Yeah.
Okay.
CC's.
No CC's. We got to get something we can bring home to Mommy. Mommy's pressure washering. Pressure washering. Pressure washing. Pressure washing? At the house. So we're going to bring her some lunch and then maybe do Hot Topic later on today. Mrs. Cincy and I are actually going to see a movie tonight. We're going to see Kingsman, The Golden Circle at 6 p.m. at the dinner theater. So we're going to eat dinner, Cinebistro, eat some dinner, see a movie. These girls are staying with their grandma, but I'll see you later. Probably from Hot Topic, probably from somewhere else, but I will see you soon. All right, so we are actually at Hot Topic. We're going to Hot Topic right now because Mrs. Cincy is apparently still pressure washing. She didn't answer her phone, so she couldn't tell me what she wanted for lunch. So we decided to go to the mall. So we're going to... Is that light on or is your door still open? Did you leave that light on?
Yeah.
Well, make sure you turn it off, girlfriend. There you go. So we're going to go to Hot Topic. I'm going to spend this hot cash. Hopefully they have the pops I'm looking for. Or, I don't know, maybe I'll get a t-shirt or something. Seriously? Your finger stuck in the goldfish box? Did you get it out? I gotta go help this child. Good lord. Hot mess bag there. Fingers stuck in a goldfish box. I'm gonna have to call 911 here. Adios. So, fellow YouTubers that are watching this video, do you ever go into a store and just like, and just forget to film? That's what just happened to me. I just went into Hot Topic and I forgot to film everything I looked at. I ended up not getting the Hopper and the Hazmat suit pop. I ended up getting a t-shirt instead. I got a Villain Club, Marty Skrull Bullet Club t-shirt. And I bought Tay-Tay a bracelet that she really wanted. And I got myself a Bullet Club sticker so that I could get to 30 bucks and use the hot cash. So that's what I got. I'll show you the t-shirt when we get back to the Nerd Bar. I don't want to pull it out now because I'm on the highway, but yeah, totally forgot to film inside that store. They didn't really have anything new. They had the Thor exclusive pop. They had, obviously, Hopper and Hazmat. They still had the they still had the Ursula, the bedazzled Ursula that's real sparkly. That pop actually looks really, really cool, but didn't get any pops, just got that t-shirt. But that's it for now. I'll see you guys later, probably from the Nerd Bar. Probably do a showcase. Or I might do some more hunting later. I'm not sure yet, but I'll see you guys later. Adios. Hi. So we're back at home. I'm joined by Mrs. Cincy.
Hello.
A lot of you guys ask what she does, and this is one of the things that she does. She is actually building a prop for Tay-Tay for Halloween made of Priority Mail boxes. If you can tell what this is the top of Harley Quinn's hammer, or mallet. So she actually is making a Harley Quinn mallet out of cardboard for Tay-Tay as a prop for Halloween. So
we'll show you the finished product.
Yep. You guys ask what she does.
This is what I do.
This is what she does. See you guys later.
Bye.
All right. There is the work in progress. Harley Quinn's mallet. And now we just need to paint it and add details.
Sit it down like this.
Whoa, pretty awesome. And you can spin it. All right, so here is the current progress of the mallet. Instead of painting it, Mrs. Cincy used electrical tape to make it red and black, but there you go. We'll show you the final product as soon as it's done. Hey, what's going on? It is date night. We are going to the Cine Bistro. Gonna get our eat on and then watch Kingsman the Golden Circle. The three of us are going. Myself, Mrs. Cincy, and this giant zit on my face.
Like the three of us.
Mount St. Helens right there. But I will join you guys from the Nerd Bar, let you know what I think about Kingsman. I love the first one. I heard this one is kind of over the top, but it's kind of the same as the first one. So I'll tell you what I think about it.
You like over the top anyway.
I do like over the top movies. So I will see
How
you guys.
How many as if moments are they going to have?
Oh, plenty. if you haven't watched like me after watching a movie, whenever she goes to one of these action movies and something kind of far-fetched or ridiculous happens, she almost loudly says, as if.
I do not say it like that.
Oh, as if. You say it just like that. But yeah, I will see you guys in the Nerd Bar. Let you know what I think. But yeah, adios. Muchachos! Why so serious? What's up, everyone? So, back from the movie. Actually, it's a few hours after we got back from the movie. I'm having a beer. It's Batman Day. It's actually the day after Batman Day, since it's like 1 in the morning right now. But I'm here to drink this beer. Hold on 1 second. I am here with my trusty sidekick, Zitty McPimpleface. We're hanging out here in the Nerd Bar. Everyone else is asleep. We're hanging out here to, one, show you my haul today. B, show you this frickin' Harley Quinn mallet that Mrs. Cincy made for Tay-Tay. For those that don't know, Tay-Tay is actually going as Harley Quinn for Halloween this year. Mrs. Cincy made her a big mallet. This thing is awesome. This thing is so cool. And she made it out of, like, cardboard. But it's solid, too. And then after that, I'm going to do a quick showcase of two Mezco figures. It's actually four Mezco figures because it's two Mezco figures. It's the Shadowland Daredevil, the Red Suit Deadpool. And I'm going to show you the comparisons between those two and the Yellow Suit Daredevil and the X-Men Suit SDCC Deadpool. So there you go. That's the rest of this video. Let's get started. I'm going to show you my haul. All right, so first things first, I got this Octone. What the frick? Octane, you mean? Come on, Hasbro. Get the licensing for the actual names of the characters. Octane, he's still awesome looking. Look at how awesome this looks. Triple changer. Robot to tanker to jumbo jet or whatever he is. Jet airliner. Plane of some kind. Looks awesome is what he is. And he looks great. He's going to look great out of package, but he's going to look excellent next to this guy, which I got earlier in the week, Blitzwing. So I got the new Blitzwing, and I still have the old Blitzwing right here. Just put this out for poops and ha-has to show you the difference between the old Thrilling 30 Blitzwing and the new, very, very awesome Titans Return Blitzwing. So there's a Blitzwing party right there. But I got that Octone. And I got this guy, Seth freaking Rollins. This is from when he debuted in, not debuted, this is from when he was the first NXT title holder back in, what, 2012 or something? But yeah, this was like his old ring attire. Seth freaking Rollins, aka Tyler Black, NXT. Really cool figure. That's the first time I've ever seen that figure at a Target. I always see the other four figures. Other three figures. I always see Austin Aries, No Way Jose, and Bailey, but I never see this one. So had to pick it up as soon as I saw it. You could see here there are two Hot Toys figures in the background. There's Harley Quinn, there is Wonder Woman, and I still need to do a showcase on both of those. So those will be coming up soon. Check out this badass mallet. Look at this thing. Mrs. Cincy made this by hand out of cardboard, a PVC pipe, and electrical tape. How awesome is this? Let me see if I can. It's got some weight to it, too. But there you go. How awesome is that? I give it about 5 to 10 minutes before Tay-Tay is tired of carrying this on Halloween night, and then I have to carry around this big mallet. And then I'm just going to hit things with it. I'm going to play like giant croquet and hit soccer balls with it. But I just think this is super cool. My wife is very, very talented. She's really into arts and craftsy stuff. And this is just really cool right here. So the last two things that I got today, I got at Hot Topic. And it is this t-shirt right here. Marty Skrull Villain Club. Part of the Bullet Club. And I got this little sticker to get to $30 so I could use my hot cash, but I'll probably put that on, I don't know, something. I have no idea. But let's go ahead and get to this showcase, because I'm excited to show you the details on these bad boys right here. I'm going to start with Daredevil, Shadowland Daredevil. I'm going to compare it to Yellow Suit Daredevil, and then I'm going to go to Deadpool after that, but let's get started. All right, so this is the Shadowland Daredevil. This was a 2016, I think it was STCC. It was one of the convention exclusives. I happened to luck out and find this on their site. They did a very, very, very short restock on these, so I got it for retail, $80. But apparently this thing goes for like $200 to $250, but he is awesome. Got the black base there with the DD on it. He's wearing his Shadowland outfit. This is actually the outfit he wears now in comic books. At least for now, he's wearing that on the Defenders comic book. Looks really, really cool. Let me show you the detail on this. The suit itself is kind of like a vinyl or leather, pleather material. Until he's got the shoulder pads there made of plastic. I've got the billy clubs that are attached to the wire in there right now because it's cool. You can kind of articulate them and make him look like he's throwing them. And there's the belt. Close up of the face sculpt. Unfortunately, this figure only comes with one face sculpt, and it's this one right here. There's his Daredevil radar sense. And let me show you the pants there. See if I can get a close up on those. Pants appear to be a different type material. It looks like that it's kind of like the vinyl on the side, but on the front, it's like a kind of like a stretchy material. Got the knee guards, the boots. Extra accessories you get with this one, you get the billy clubs without the wire. That little plastic peg there is the foot peg if you're not using the dynamic stand. But I'm using the dynamic stand right now, so I have the foot peg right there. Got the open hands. Got the, I don't know, like you're catching a punch hand. And then you got these hands right here, which you can also use to make it look like he's holding the billy clubs right there. And then there's another throwing hand right there, and then a fisted hand. So he doesn't come with many accessories or additional parts, but he is still very, very limited, very cool. I really like this figure a lot. And just to show you a comparison, here is the yellow suit Daredevil, which I also really love this outfit. It screams like 70s comic books, but still, it just looks cool. Mezco did a really, really good job with these, but there you go. I wanted to show you a side-by-side between the oldest Daredevil outfit and the newest in the comic books. So there you go. Pretty freaking cool. And there's Seth freaking Rollins. All right, so moving on. This guy looks phenomenal. Comes with a ton of accessories. This is Deadpool, obviously. Red suit Deadpool. There's the box. But I never showed you the 360 of the Daredevil, so let me just do that real quick. He does have the holders for the billy clubs right there. Not much detail in the back. It's kind of the leather, pleather, vinyl material on the back. Whoop! His billy club just went where it shouldn't go. I did not do that on purpose. Sorry, Harley. Sorry about that. So going back to Deadpool, lots of accessories with this Deadpool. So first things first, see those grenades there on the shoulders? Those were all loose, but I put them in the little holsters there. So you get six of those grenades. Those grenades are for the gun there, which I'm not sure on the kind of gun. I said it was an AR-14 at one point, but I think that might be wrong. It does have a grenade launcher on it, though. The detail on the gun itself is very, very awesome. Cool paint on the gun. You got gunmetal, some scratches, some wear. Sights, scope, awesome. I have his, I call it a hang loose hand right there. That's what I do that a lot myself. But I like that hand, that's cool. These little grenades I added on. See the red grenade there on the waists? Those I added on. They just hang there. There's two additional ones that you can that you get with the figure, but I didn't really have any place to put those, so they're just down there. Pistols. So those pistols are in his holsters. They do come out, but I have them all holstered up right there. They have the little Deadpool symbol on the, what is that called? Handle of the pistol? The Glock? Handle? I think that's right. And he comes with two of those Glocks right there. And the outfit itself is two, kind of like the Daredevil with the pants there. See how it's got like the vinyl like slash pleather and then the stretchy material? It's two different materials there. Same thing with this. So it's got the stretchy material, but it's also got the vinyl slash pleather on the sides. It does not restrict the posability very much. As you can see, his arms are that like vinyl pleather material, but it bends very, very well. And from what I've seen, I've had him in a couple poses, it bends back. So if you have him in like a dynamic pose like this, where the arm is kind of stretched and the fabric is getting stretched, it should spring back. But don't quote me on that, just be careful when you're posing these. I don't want you to say, Cincy, I thought you said it was cool, and look at this frickin' figure now. It's all stretched out. But it looks like it springs back. At least on mine it does. There's the head sculpt, by the way. And show you the legs, the boots, and the shin guards. That one shin guard is a little crooked. I gotta fix that one. And there's the base. Deadpool symbol. Let me show you the back of the figure, because he does come with removable katanas. These are removable, as you can see here. And get that to focus. Nope, not gonna happen. Okay. Put that back in there. But pretty cool sheaths there. Pretty awesome. Some leg straps for the Glock. What is that called? That is called holster. The Glock holster. It is 1 o'clock in the morning, ladies and gentlemen, so I'm a little tired. So I'm forgetting regular words and common words like holster. Couldn't think of that. But there you go. This is an awesome figure. I love this figure. I love Mezco. This is probably one of my favorite figures of the year. At least top 10, I would say. Definitely one of my favorite Mezco figures that I've purchased this year. But just an awesome, awesome figure all around. It helps that I love the character Deadpool. I love the movie. I read a lot of the comic books. I see a lot of myself in Deadpool. I kind of have a very, very dry, sarcastic sense of humor. But I don't know. I just like the character a lot. Here's the accessories that he comes with. So there's the two additional grenades. Here's the additional head sculpt where it's like one open, one kind of... It looks like he's kind of winking or like doing a... I don't know. Like he just smelled a fart or something. Like one eye open, one eye kind of like, what? He comes with... I think those are fisted hands. Fisted hands there. Those hands are for holding the guns, the Glocks. Those hands are for holding the katanas. And that's what he comes with. I have most of his accessories already on him. With the guns, the grenades, the gun, the rifle, the frickin' grenades, more grenades, swords. He's decked out. But I would highly, highly recommend this figure if you're interested in if you're interested in collecting Mezcos. A lot of people ask me a question, what Mezco should I start with? This is a damn good figure to start with if you're going to start collecting Mezcos. This one, and I would say Punisher. But Punisher is getting harder to find. If you're into Marvel, this is the one to go with. It's Deadpool. He looks awesome. So I would, I would say this one is a great one to start with. And just to compare, here is the SDCC Deadpool with the X-Men outfit. So here is the side-by-side. Let me see if I can move them a little closer together without knocking any accessories off the nerd bar. Here's the side-by-side comparison. Deadpools. And I think I might use this as my thumbnail. Right there. That's the money shot. So that's it. That's it for this video. Thank you for joining me. This video had a little bit of everything. Had a little showcase action, had a haul action, some hunting. Hunting with the girls. Hijinks with the girls in a Target. A little movie date action with Mrs. Cincy. A little special appearance by Mrs. Cincy in the video. This was a cool video. I liked this one. I liked filming this one. But I will definitely see you in the next video. But for right now, I'd like to thank you. Thank you so much for liking this video, commenting on it, subscribing to my channel, sharing this video, and just for watching this video. It looks like a frickin' tornado went through behind me. Just a lot of mess back there. But I'm gonna enjoy the rest of this beer out of my Batman glass. Again, happy Batman Day. I don't know if I mentioned it earlier. Oh, I did mention it. I did pre-order the Ascending Knight Mezco exclusive Batman Day Batman in the black outfit. Excited to get that one. Doesn't ship till January, but I did pre-order that one. So I figured that one was going to be kind of limited since it was for Batman Day. I'm not sure how many pieces they created, but it looks awesome and I'm looking forward to it. So again, Mezco, toy line of the year, in my personal opinion. I still love Hot Toys, but I have really, really fallen hard into this Mezco addiction. It's a great addiction to have, though. Awesome figures, awesome collectibles. I said this earlier, they feel like little posable pieces of art to me. They don't feel like action figures. They don't feel like toys. They feel like little pieces of art that I can move around and put in different poses. It's pretty awesome. But that's it for now. I'm done rambling. I'm going to drink this beer before it gets warm. Have a good night and have fun collecting. I'll see you guys in the next video. Ziddy McPimpleface also says adios, and we'll see you later.